I'm here with Dr. Laszlo Tabar, and he and his colleagues have written a book titled Understanding the Breast in Health and Disease. So, Dr. Tabar, why is it so important for women to understand their breasts?
Lisa, the breast has a very complex structure. Unlike other organs in the body, it varies from woman to woman, and also it may vary a lot from decade to decade. I can demonstrate this by showing you mammograms. Here are the mammograms of five different women. And you see the composition, the structure. This is what we call a dense breast. This one we call a dense breast too, and this one too. But these are three versions of the so-called dense breast. And this one is totally fatty replaced. And it's partly dense and partly fatty replaced. So the varieties are enormous. Unlike, for example, the lungs, one chest x-ray doesn't differ very much from another chest x-ray. One woman's kidneys are not very different from another woman's kidneys. Why is it so that the mammograms or the composition of the normal breast is so different? I think women should know about it. In addition, the benign and malignant breast diseases are extremely heterogeneous. So what we want to accomplish by informing women about these varieties is that they should be aware of which mammographic parenchyma patterns they belong to. Because here in this entirely fatty replaced breast, I can find the tiniest benign or malignant lesion. But I cannot provide the same service here. And I have a very difficult task in finding, for example, a 1 centimeter cancer in this breast. Mm-hmm. I would very much like women understand this variation. And I'd like to show you also this compared with three-dimensional histology. Every woman would understand that this breast has a lot of glandular tissue where the milk is produced. Mm-hmm. And this is actually the blueprint of this mammogram. I'm just imaging the underlying beautiful nature. This is a milk duct. This is a milk duct full of fluid. And let me call it a springtime. That is, these milk factories are hormone sensitive. They are really reacting, producing fluid. And this results in the intestine issue. But this one is a wintertime. That is, the milk factories are already regressed, they disappeared. Just the skinny branches of the duct or the tree and its branches are seen. So it's very easy for me to find any benign or malignant lesion in it.
So you're talking about wintertime versus springtime. Is there an age difference between these women?
Yes and no. This woman can be a 25-year-old woman. But when she becomes pregnant, then springtime comes. So it's a very interestingly dynamic and complex organ. It changes a lot. Our lungs don't change. Our other organs don't change to this level that we can demonstrate the change. So that's why it is an extremely difficult task to read mammograms. And I just want to let women know these varieties of the normals so they can understand why one woman has a breast pain and the other woman doesn't even understand what breast pain is. Why one woman's mammogram is easy to read, why a woman with dense breast has a problem, both when concerning breast pain and the physicians have a problem in finding very small cancers in those breasts as well.
Thank you so much for joining us here at Breast Cancer Answers, Doctor. Every woman should purchase this book. And again, the name of it is Understanding the Breast in Health and Disease. You can pick it up at Amazon.com, or you can also get it at mammographyed.com. Now, in addition to the book, there's more. There's also video commentaries that can give you more information on why it's very important to understand your breasts. For Breast Cancer Answers, I'm Lisa Schneider-Cipriano.